Most people struggle to answer the question, what is Bitcoin? Because there are just so many different ways to respond. First, Bitcoin is considered the first and most widely used cryptocurrency. A cryptocurrency is a completely digital, decentralized currency that is built using principles of computer science, cryptography, and economics. The term Bitcoin refers to the protocol governing this currency. Second, Bitcoin lowercase refers to the actual units of the currency. A Bitcoin user will say that they have a certain amount of Bitcoins, which is similar to how we say we have a certain amount of dollars when referring to the US dollars. Third, Bitcoin is also the inspiration for the blockchain, which is the underlying data structure of this cryptocurrency. A data structure is a virtual format for organizing, retrieving, and storing information. The Bitcoin blockchain in particular stores a permanent history of all transactions to ever occur in the history of Bitcoin. It is an append-only ledger, meaning that any information added to the ledger cannot be deleted. But most importantly, Bitcoin is a cultural revolution. It is rooted in ideals from cypherpunks and libertarians. And Bitcoin represents a shift towards privacy and decentralization. This cryptocurrency is not backed by any central organizations, including government or companies. Instead, Bitcoin is built by the users and for the users. As we said, Bitcoin was inspired by the cypherpunk movement of the late 80s. Cypherpunks advocate for the protection of privacy using cryptography. They don't trust governments, corporations, or large organizations to respect privacy. These points of centralization, in their opinions, accumulate a great deal of power over society by collecting unimaginable amounts of information from millions of users. And the cypherpunks were some of the first to be concerned about central entities stripping away the freedom of the general public. One massive point of centralization in modern day society is the financial system, where banks govern the economies of entire countries. Several different companies and researchers attempted to make a decentralized or anonymous currency, but all of them failed. And Bitcoin was the first technology to succeed as a currency. The Bitcoin white paper, or research paper, was published in October 2008 by Satoshi Nakamoto. The white paper was a 9-page concise proposal for the structure and function of a peer-to-peer electronic currency. Satoshi Nakamoto is a pseudonym, or a false identity, of an individual or a group of individuals, but no one knows what their real identity is. However, what's important is that this white paper envisioned a currency where users do not rely on financial intermediaries or do not have to trust anyone in order to make transaction with each other. In Bitcoin, users do not need to use their real-world identities. Instead, they are represented by addresses, strings of random letters, and numbers. Bitcoin takes control out of the hands of third parties and gives users the freedom to transact while protecting their privacy. So, how does Bitcoin do it? On a high level, the Bitcoin network validates transactions and stores the entire transaction history. And the Bitcoin network is a group of users communicating with each other as part of the Bitcoin protocol. This network serves as the substitute for the central bank and must have certain properties to function correctly. Bitcoin is trying to create an open and accessible cryptocurrency not subject to censorship or centralization. But what could be the problems? Well, there are no central parties to ask for information about users' accounts, and there's no one to really kick out anyone or censor malicious users. Decentralized networks generally suffer from these problems, leading to inconsistencies between parties and malicious messages infecting the network. The most popular attack is the double spending attack, where some value is used for more than it's worth. In real life, it's easy to prevent double spending, since dollar bills cannot be copied and pasted. However, in digital currencies, there needs to be assurance that the virtual tokens have not been promised to more than one person. Bitcoin, as a technology, is trying to solve a very specific problem in the realm of distributed systems. When any node or computer within the network can come and leave as it pleases and behave however it likes, there are enormous possibilities for failures given the complete removal of centralization. And this is also why so many Bitcoin's predecessors have failed. So how does Bitcoin solve these problems? Bitcoin solves these problems through two things. First, the blockchain. Second, proof of work. Both of them are Satoshi Nakamoto's most popular and influential innovations. Because of these two things, anyone with access to internet and a computer can join the Bitcoin network. There are no banks or any equivalent of the Federal Reserve on the Bitcoin network. Instead, everyone can verify and audit the transaction history on their own. And even the creation of money is decided not by a central authority, but through the process of mining or proof of work.